So now it's time for you to meet our second computer scientist, Bob. Bob is working in biotechnology or bioinformatics. And the problem that Bob is working on is he's doing gene analysis. So he's looking at a bunch of different genes, such as these one here. So Bob is basically trying to figure out how genes work together, which groups of genes get activated, say, when a cell develops a disease or when it's infected, as opposed to the healthy cell. So Bob will receive data from a laboratory that will tell him which genes work together or which get activated under certain conditions and which genes don't. So for example, these two genes here will get activated more or less under the same conditions. Also these two here, but these two here, they appear to be kind of independent in laboratory research. So of course, Bob does not only receive data on two genes, but on a number of genes. And of course, there are many more interactions. So it's a group of genes that tends to work together quite a lot. And so since Bob is trying to figure out which groups of genes work together, what he's basically looking for is a collection of genes that are all connected to each other. So I'll just give you one example. This here, these three genes are all connected to each other. So this is kind of the type of group that he's looking for. What he would not be looking for example, something like this, these four genes here. Most of them are connected to each other, but not every single one of them is connected to every other. So this gene here is not connected to that one. And the reason why he's looking for these clusters of genes is that when you find a group of genes where each gene displays a very similar behavior to every other gene, then you have a kind of functional cluster. So a large set of genes that can be assumed to be involved in the same processes. And you can then use this for drug targeting or figuring more out about the disease. So this problem is a bit of a simplification of what you might encounter in a real biotechnology setting. For example, you'd normally be content with these four genes here that are not all fully connected. But looking for genes where every gene is connected to every other one is a bit more convenient to work with. And actually, it doesn't really make much of a difference from an algorithmic perspective. So let's say it's realistic enough.